everyone. My name is Karen Joanna Sampson. I am from class 5C. For today's occasion, the Bible reading is taken from the book of Psalms, chapter 145, verses 1 to 12. I will extol you, my God, O King, and I will bless your name forever and ever. Every day I will bless you, and I will praise your name forever and ever. Great is the Lord, and greatly to be praised, and his greatness is unsearchable. One generation shall praise your works to another, and shall declare your mighty acts. I will meditate on the glorious splendor of your majesty, and on your wondrous works. Men shall speak of the might of your awesome acts, and I will declare your greatness. They shall utter the memory of your great goodness and shall sing of your righteousness. The Lord is gracious and full of compassion, slow to anger, and great in mercy. The Lord is good to all, and his tender mercies are over all his works. All your works shall praise you, O Lord, and your saints shall bless you. They shall speak of the glory of your kingdom and talk of your power, to make known to the sons of men his mighty acts and the glorious majesty of his kingdom. Amen. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Reformer who started the age of enlightenment. Rajaram Mohan Roy was born on 22nd May 1772 in an Orthodox Brahmin family at Radhanagar in Bengal. Rajaram Mohan Roy's early education includes the studies of Persian and Arabic along with Sanskrit. At the age of 16, he wrote Rational Critique of Hindu Idol Worship. From 1803 to 1814, he worked for East India Company and resigned his job and moved to Calcutta in order to devote his life to religious, social and political reforms. He greatly influenced by the Western moral thoughts and stressed on rationalism and modern scientific approaches. He believed that each sinner must make restitution for his sins and it should be done through self-purification and repentance. He believed in social equality of all human beings and thus was a strong opposer of caste system. He believed that unless women were freed from oppressions like illiteracy, child marriage, sati and parda, Hindu society cannot progress. Rajaram Mohan Roy from Brahmo Sabha in 1828. Rajaram Mohan Roy was one of the few people in his time to realize significant and modern age. Thank you.
Thank you, Jennifer Veronica, for a wonderful speech. Now, I welcome our first judge, Mrs. Dolly Varghese, who is judging class 3rd and 4th.
I would like to extend my gratitude to the principal, headmistress and teachers of St. Mary's Girls Matriculation Higher Secondary School for giving me this opportunity. Children, it was indeed a great pleasure for me to have been a part of this social science project. Congratulations to all the participants. Now I am going to announce the winners. So the winners of class 3rd, the first place goes to Srinidhi K.S. The second place goes to Shabaz S. The third place goes to Kavileya V.
Hello everybody, my name is Srinidhi. I'm studying in St. Mary's Girls High Secondary School in 3rd Standard E section. I'm going to say about safety rules on road. Road safety rules safeguards the commuters and pedestrians from road accidents and save their valuable lives. There are a few essential safety rules in India which if followed strictly could avoid a major number of accidents. Wearing helmets in two-wheelers and wearing seatbelts in four-wheelers are one of the most important safety rules. Drunk and driving, overloading things, jumping red light are few reasons for road accidents which should be completely avoided. Always drive at nominal speed and do not overspeed your vehicles. Always stop at red light and move only at green light. Pedestrians should always walk on the footpaths and use zebra crossing bikes crossing the road. Driving in your own lane is the best rule to avoid accidents. Never receive calls or talk on your cell phone while driving. In case it is urgent, always stop the vehicle outside and receive the calls. Always respect pedestrians and own their vehicles on the road and do not engage in any conflicts. Thank you.
Stop! No entry! Give way! On one-way traffic, no left turn, no right turn, etc. These are safety rule symbols.
Hi everybody, my name is Shabash. Do you know who I am? I am a milkman. Cows and buffalo give milk. I wake up early in the morning. I collect milk from the cow. Daily morning, I come to your house and deliver milk. I give diet to my cow so they give healthy and tasty milk. I carry in big container over this bicycle. We should drink milk
They are smaller nuclear family, larger extended family, joint family. Importance of family is seen more during the time of our hardships. Family is the primary source of learning any types of social skills. Family fulfills our basic needs like food, shelter, clothing, and education. Family makes us feel secured and comfortable. One can learn moral values like respect our elders, sharing, caring one another, discipline and manners from family members. Interdependence of family members helps in becoming good citizen and develop harmony. Family is the helps in our various development like mental, social, physical and emotional. It demands us less and gives us more as possible. Last but not least, family plays a very important role in making today's children into tomorrow's leader. Thank you for giving me this opportunity.
Next, the prize winners of Standard 4. The first place goes to Joshua S. The second place goes to Arshia Kauser. The third place goes to J. Sipora Alice. Thank you, my dear children.
Good morning to everyone. My name is S. Joshua. My topic is Tamil Nadu tourism. Tourism is an essential part of the life of the society because of its direct impact on social, cultural, educational and economic sector of the nation and on the international relations too. Tamil Nadu tourism, one of the preferred hotspots for persons wanting a continuing heritage, cultural and beautiful splendor religious experience. Tamil Nadu is breathtaking hill stations and long sunshining beaches provides to people who visit not only to marinate in the culture but people was relax and just let go for a while. The three main components of tourism are attraction, accessibility and amenities. Attraction. Attraction mainly comprised of two types such as natural attraction and cultural attraction. Now, I am going to show you the most important places in Tamil Nadu. Merna Beach. Merna Beach happens to India's longest and world's second longest beach. The entire avenue with the lighthouse in its proximity is a heritage and probably one of the best places to visit in Tamil Nadu. Tiruvalluvar statue. Tiruvalluvar is the immortal poet of Tamil Nadu and is given to the world. Tirukkural. The memorial statue of Tiruvalluvar is in Kanyakumari. Kanyakumari rests at the position where the Indian Ocean, the Bay of Bengal and Arabian Sea join. Tanjai Periya Kovil. Tanjavur Periya Kovil or Rajarajeshwara Temple is one of the largest temples in India, built by Empire Rajaraja Cholan in the year of 1010. Kutralam. Kutralam Falls is located in Tenkasi district and is considered a medical spa on account of the medical smell in the waters. Ooty. Ooty is queen of hills and one of the best hill stations. This cool temperature and wonderful natural sceneries are the center of attraction. Nothing teaches you life better than traveling. So travel to expand your knowledge. Thank you.
Good morning to all. My name is S. Arshia Kausa. I'm studying in 4D. Today I'm talk about child labor. In India, millions of children are forced into child labor due to poverty, high literacy rates, due to lack of education, unemployment, overpopulation, etc. As reported by Save the Children. Children between the ages of 14 to 17 years engage in hazardous work and account for 62.8% of India's child labor workforce in in which more boys than girls are forced into doing more hazardous work. As reported by UNICEF, there has been 54% increase in child labor in urbanized area for children between the ages of 5 to 14. In addition, according to the Campaign Against Child Labor study, India has approximately 1,26,66,377 child laborers total. Uttar Pradesh, a state in northern India, has 19,27,997 child neighbors. Delhi, the capital of the India, has over 1 million child neighbors. Other learning states with similar figure include Bihar, Rajasthan, Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, and Uttar Pradesh. Article 24 of the Constitution early states that no child below the age of 14 years shall be employed for work in any factory or mill or employed in any hazardous employment. The Child Labour Act of 1986 designates a child as a person who has not completed their 14th year. Thank you.
I'm Daisy Borellis, studying in fourth. I'm going to tell you about Tamil Nadu tourism. Tamil Nadu has the largest tourism industry in India. I'm going to talking about Mahabalipuram. Mahabalipuram, also known as Mamallapuram, is a town in Chengalpattu district. It's one of the famous tourist sites in India. Shiva Temple. Shiva Temple is the complex of temples and shrines that overlook the shore of the Bay of Bengal, built with grand blocks of granite, dating from the 8th century. It is one of the oldest structural stone temples of South India. Descent of the Ganges. Descent of the Ganges is a monument at Mahabalipuram. It is a giant open-air rock relief carved on two monolithic rock boulders. Panjaradas. Panjaradas, also known as Five Radas or Pandava Radas. Panjaradas is an example for monolithic rocket architecture. It's for the five Pandava brothers. Significant characters of the Indian epic Mahabharata. Krishna's Butterball, also known as Paniraikal. Approximately 6 meters high, 5 meters wide, and weighs around 250 tons. Valley stands on a slope on top of 1.2 meters at the same place for 1,200 years. Seashell Museum. The museum has 20,000 shells, conches, corals, and fossils on display. The impressive lighthouse stands on the rocky patches near the Mahabalipuram shore. Beach. This is an excellent clean and clear water beach.
Now, I call upon Mrs. Mohana Priya, judge of class 5.
Hello everyone. Children, aim higher. Shoot for the moon. Even if you miss it, you will land among the stars. Let me congratulate all the children, those who participated in this social expo. Now, it is time to announce the result of the social expo conducted by St. Mary's Matriculation Girls Higher Secondary School. First prize shared by two children, V. Hemashree of 5B and R. Vishal of 5A, for the topic Monuments of India. Second prize goes to K. Tanishka of 5A for our topic Radiation from Mobile Towers. Third prize goes to Trinitra of 5C for our topic Prehistoric Period. I congratulate the winners. Best of luck, children. Thank you.
Good morning, madam. My name is V. Hemashree from 5th standard. My topic is Monuments.
any kind of beauty can ever have. One of the seven wonders of the world. Taj Mahal is located on the banks of river Yamuna in Agra, Indian state of Uttar Pradesh. Gateway of India. Gateway of India is an arch monument built in the early 20th century in the city of Mumbai. Shisho Temple. Shisho Temple located in Mamallapuram, Bay of Bengal is one of the main attraction of the Mamallapuram built by 700 to 728. Vivekananda Memorial is a monument in Kanyakumari. It was built in 1970 in honor of Swami Vivekananda. India's one of the greatest saint and leader, Swami Vivekananda. Golden Temple, located on the heart of Amritsar. The Golden Temple is most admired Gurudwara in the country. Lord Buddha meditated. Named after the gold covering, Baba Deep Singh died in the Golden Temple. Madurai Meenakshi. Arulmigu Meenakshi Sundareshwara Temple is a Hindu temple located on the Vaigai River in the temple of Madurai. Thank you.
A warm welcome to everyone. I am Arvishal of 5A. Here I am going to talk about monuments of India. In India, there are many monuments of India such as Taj Mahal, Qutub Minar, Red Fort, India Gate, Ajanta Caves, etc. I have choose to tell about Red Fort and India Gate. Red Fort was built by the Mughal Empire, Shahjahan in New Delhi, India in the year 1648. Red Fort is one of the famous historical monuments in India. In Hindi, the Red Fort was popularly known as Hal Kula. The wall of Red Fort are built using 30 meter high red sandstone and marbles. Red Fort construction took almost 10 years. It began from 1638 and got over in 1648. Red Fort is one of the attractive destination for tourists around the globe. India Gate. India Gate was built in honor of the soldiers of India who were martyred during the First World War. It represents the bravery and sacrifice of Indian soldiers. Every year on 26th January, Republic Day parade takes place at India Gate. The foundation stone was laid for India Gate on 10th February 1921 and it was officially inaugurated in 1931. India Gate fills with the feeling and emotion of patriotism as well as love and respect towards India as our motherland. Thank you.
My name is Tanishka. I want to tell you about a social issue, radiation from mobile towers. Radiation is a emission of energy from any source, even heat from your body count as radiation. Some form of radiation make you sick. Electromagnetic radiation from cell phone towers is largely contained of high frequency radio waves. Electromagnetic range includes low frequency radiation such as computer and power lines, medium frequency radiation such as television and radio, high frequency radiation such as microwave and mobile devices. Radio frequency radiation is emitted as different frequencies are cell phone towers, cell phone, computer, Wi-Fi and other electronic devices. Let us discuss about disadvantages of mobile tower. Large number of birds like pigeon, swarm, etc. getting lost due to unseen enemy. Example, mobile tower. Addition of more cell phone towers in cities are the reason for decreased bird population and increased health hazards in human. Apart from birds and animals, electromagnetic radiation coming from cell phone tower can also affect crop, vegetable, plant in its locality. Disturbed sleep, headaches, brain tumors, fatigue, joint pain, heart disorders, DNA damage and cancer are some of the health hazards due to cell phone tower radiation. How can we save ourselves from radiation? We should minimize the use of phone as much as we can. Prefer to make only important calls or cut down your talking time to minimal. Try to connect to text messages instead of making call to cause less radiation. Avoid playing games using mobile phone, which causes brain damage in humans. Disable wireless function including routers, printers, tablets and laptop which emit Wi-Fi signal at home. Stay safe, stay healthy, reduce radiation and let the humans live in the healthy future. Thank you.
Good morning everybody. I'm going to talk about prehistoric period. The word history is derived from the Greek word historia, meaning inquiry. History is the study of the past. Prehistory is the study of events before the invention of writing. It roughly starts from 2.5 million years ago. Aichanur and Kilari are famous sites for prehistoric period in Tamil Nadu. The Stone Age is the first period of prehistory. The Stone Age has three phases, namely the Paleolithic Age, Mesolithic Age and Neolithic Age. Early man lived in jungle. They hunt and gather food. They ate raw flesh and fruits. The discovery of fire helped them to cook food, provide warmth and have light source at night. Humans started building shelters with animal skin and leaves. Tugboats were used for fishing. The uses of bow and arrow began. The invention of stoneware, making of pottery and chattel agriculture were the major developments in Neolithic Age. The Bronze Age came after the Stone Age. Copper was the first metal to be used. Later, bronze, an alloy of copper, was used and replaced in tools and weapons. The Iron Age followed the Bronze Age. New civilization and writing developed. Thus, written historical period started. Thank you.
Now it's time to wind up. Now let me call Yarni of Standard 5A to deliver the vote of thanks.
A very good morning to our Honorable Chairman, Correspondent, Board of Trustees, Principal, Vice Principal, Headmistress, Teachers, Parents and my dear friends. I, Yali of Standard 5A, it's my privilege to propose the vote of thanks and acknowledge the contribution of those who work really hard to make this social day event happen. First of all, I would like to thank the Almighty God for making today's event a successful one. A special thanks to the judges of the day, Mrs. Mohana Priya and Mrs. Dolly Burgess, who have taken time off their busy schedule to give the judgment. Your words of wisdom will surely encourage us in the future event. Last but not least, I would like to thank the editing, composing team of Very Proactive and parents for their fullest support and dedicated staff without whose support this event would not have been a memorable one. My sincere thanks to each and everyone present for the event for making this a grand success. Jai Hind. Thank you.